Hi guys, David and David here from payitforward.com, and in this video we're going to explain what to do when your iPhone keeps restarting.
When your iPhone keeps restarting, one of two things is going on. Either your iPhone is restarting every once in a while, or it's restarting all the time. So we're going to start with dealing with the basic issues that cause iPhones to restart every once in a while, and then we'll move on to the more complicated fixes.
And if you're in one of those scenarios where your iPhone keeps restarting over and over and over again, you might want to skip a little bit ahead in this video because the first four steps aren't going to work for you.
Mm-hmm.
But step number one is to back up your iPhone if you can.
Right. When an iPhone keeps restarting like this, it can be indicative of a pretty bad software problem or a hardware problem. So back it up while you still can. Connect your iPhone to iTunes on your computer or do an iCloud backup. Whatever works, just back it up first.
Yep.
Our next step is to update your iPhone software. How do we do that?
Well, let's open up the Settings app, scroll down to General, tap Software Update. It'll check for an update. I do have a software update available.
You
I won't download and install it now because then that'll turn my iPhone off.
Mm-hmm.
But tap Download and Install. It'll download the update, then install the update, and hopefully that'll fix your problem.
Mm-hmm. This update also includes bug fixes and improvements.
Well, that
could
be it.
That could fix the problem.
That could be it right there.
There you go.
So our third step is to make sure it's not an app that's actually causing the problem.
Mm-hmm. And the way we can check this is by taking a look at the iPhone analytics on your iPhone. So let's open the Settings app, and then head to Privacy, and then scroll all the way to the bottom to Analytics, and then take a look at Analytics Data. This is a pretty technical list. I want you just to scroll through this list and see if any one app starts to appear over and over and over again. You don't really need to know much about it, but if you see the same app just repeated and repeated and repeated, there could be a problem with that app. So I noticed at the top of here, David had some ESPN issues.
Yep. Let's go back up there.
Mm-hmm.
ESPN scores widget.
Right.
That could be the problem right there.
Could be a problem. Generally, app problems don't cause your iPhone to restart. You might be using an app and then you're right back on your iPhone's home screen. And you're like, what happened? The app disappeared. Mm-hmm. That's an app crash.
Yep.
But occasionally, it can happen. So if you find an app that's causing a lot of problems on your iPhone, I recommend deleting the app and reinstalling it, redownloading it from the App Store.
Or just to be safe, why don't we just close out of all the apps on our iPhone right now, just in case one of them crashed. To do that, iPhone 8 or earlier, double press the home button. iPhone 10, swipe up from the bottom to the center of the screen. iPhone 8 and earlier, you're going to swipe them right off the top of the screen. iPhone 10, first press and hold till the minus button appears, then swipe.
Mm-hmm.
Apps are closed.
Our next fix is going to be to reset all settings on your iPhone.
Yep.
This is kind of a magic bullet that solves a lot of iPhone software problems, and it's a good in-between step between just uninstalling an app, let's say, and erasing everything in your iPhone and setting it up from scratch. How do we do it? Go to the Settings app. And then we're going to go to General, scroll down to Reset, and then we're going to tap Reset All Settings. Basically, it takes everything out of the Settings app, so you are going to have to set up your wallpaper again, for instance, and re-enter your Wi-Fi password, but it's not going to delete any of your personal data from your iPhone.
Yep, so you enter your passcode, tap Reset All Settings, confirmation, your iPhone will turn off, reset, turn back on.
Hopefully, this solves the problem.
If it doesn't, our next step is to eject and reinsert your SIM card.
Right, and so to do this, we're gonna have to pop open the SIM tray on the side of your iPhone using the SIM card ejector tool that we forgot to get.
It's right here, don't worry.
Damn it, there it is. All right, so on the side of your iPhone, I like how you let me do this. It's really not that hard. You can use a paperclip. So all we need is a little paperclip. But you can put this in the side of your iPhone, press down, out pops the SIM tray. So your SIM card contains your telephone number, essentially. It's what allows your iPhone to connect to your carrier. If you take out your SIM card and your iPhone stops restarting, then it was a problem, obviously, with your iPhone's connection to the carrier.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes just taking it out and putting it back in again will solve the problem. If it stops happening when you take it out, but reappears once you put it back in, however, it's time to take a trip to your carrier and replace your SIM card. A lot of times that'll solve the problem.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
If that doesn't work, don't worry. We still have one more step, and that is the DFU restore.
A DFU restore is the deepest type of restore that you can do on an iPhone. If a software problem is causing your iPhone to restart, a DFU restore is going to fix that problem. So we have a great video on it.
Link to it above in a card, below in the description. We have videos for the iPhone 7, 8, and 10.
This is the go-to fix for Apple techs. If you bring it to an Apple store, before they'll decide it's a hardware problem, they'll try a DFU restore. So try it yourself. If it doesn't work and you still have this problem, it probably is a hardware problem. We have multiple repair options.
First of all, there is the Apple Store. If you have AppleCare Plus, bring it into your local Apple Store. Schedule an appointment first, though.
Mm-hmm.
We also recommend Pulse, a third-party repair company. We'll send a tech to you, fix your iPhone on the spot.
So that's what to do if your iPhone keeps restarting. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click that notifications bell to get an immediate update whenever we upload a new video. So that's about all we got.
That's what. Yeah. You got it.